In this video, we will understand the operational principle of the logical camera. A logical camera outputs model names and model poses. And how are these models created? We, as users, have to create these models as .stl or .dae files using open source tools like MeshLab or Blender or paid tools like SolidWorks. And learning these tools is not the goal for this week. So we have provided all these models with the relevant files for this week. What is important is the way the logical camera does its job of giving us the pose. The logical camera detects and recognizes an object that intersects with its frustum and uses the frustum geometry to compute the pose of the object in 3D. Here is a simple illustration of the logical camera frustum. The white pyramidal outline that we see around the gray box is the camera frustum. And the gray box is the object of interest. And this is how the logical camera will look like when we add it to our factory simulation in the assignments for this week. It is, however, important to remember a few things. Logical camera is only a simulation concept. Real-world applications, as on today, do need 2D and 3D cameras for robot vision. And typically, real-world robot vision solutions using ROS leverage open-source libraries such as the Point Cloud library and the Open Computer Vision or OpenCV library for object detection, recognition, and pose estimation. Nowadays, deep learning-based solutions are also becoming extremely popular for robot vision solutions using deep learning frameworks such as TensorFlow. But for us in this course, what is important is we need to get a pose of our target object for manipulation. Let's continue our pursuit of this goal in the next video.